Steam enters a nozzle at 500 degrees Celsius and 1 megapascal with a velocity of 8 meters per second and leaves at 450 degrees Celsius and 600 kilopascals while losing heat at a rate of 120 kilowatts. For an inlet area of 700 square centimeters, determine the velocity and the volumetric flow rate of the steam at the nozzle exit. Remember to pause here and try to solve this problem yourself before watching the solution. This is the first example for the pipe flow, nozzles, diffusers, and throttling devices main lecture. The link to that 9-minute lecture, the other examples on this topic, and all the other lectures of the thermo course are found in the description below. The simplified energy conservation equation for nozzles that we developed in the main lecture video didn't show the heat flow term, and in general that's still correct. But if explicitly specified, like it is in this problem, that there is heat coming out of the system, we will of course include the Q dot term. From this equation, we realize that because we already have the heat transfer rate and the inlet velocity, we can find the exit velocity if we first determine the specific enthalpy at the inlet and at the exit, which we can probably do because we have pressure and temperature at both sides, and the mass flow rate, which will be the same at the inlet and at the exit. So let's work on these. Mass flow rate first and enthalpies second. From the main lecture video, we know that mass flow rate is the velocity times area over the specific volume. If this were an ideal gas, we could use the ideal gas equation to solve for the specific volume, but since this is not an ideal gas, we go to the tables. As we've always done, if you're uncertain of what phase the water is in at the inlet, you could start by looking at the saturated liquid vapor tables by temperature or pressure. Since the saturation temperature for our current pressure of 1000 kilopascals is 179.88, and our inlet temperature is 500 degrees Celsius, we can confidently say that our steam is indeed at a superheated vapor phase. Knowing that we have a superheated vapor, we go to the superheated vapor tables and look for the inlet pressure subtable for 1 megapascal and the inlet temperature value of 500 degrees Celsius to find that the specific volume is 0.354 cubic meters per kilogram. With this information and substituting the other values, we can calculate the mass flow rate. And again, this is the mass flow rate coming in and coming out. As for the specific enthalpy values for the inlet and the outlet, we can use the same superheated vapor tables using the temperature and pressure information. For the inlet, we have the same subtable for the 1 megapascal pressure and the same 500 degrees Celsius temperature value to find the specific enthalpy HI of 3479 kilojoules per kilogram. For the exit, we find the subtable for 600 kilopascals and a temperature value of 450 degrees Celsius to write down the specific enthalpy at the exit, HE, as the average of the enthalpy for 400 and 500 degrees Celsius, using basic interpolation. With this information, we carefully solve for the velocity of the fluid at the exit, substitute all the values that we found and that were given, including assigning a negative sign to the heat coming out of the system, and most importantly, account for the units that we pointed out during the flow work main lecture video, link below. We do this to find that the exit velocity is 229 meters per second. Now for the volumetric flow rate, which is the mass flow rate times the specific volume at the exit, we don't use velocity times exit area because we don't have the exit area here. We look up the specific volume at 600 kilopascals and 450 degrees Celsius and interpolate again between 400 and 500 to write it as 0.55287 cubic meters per kilogram. The volumetric flow rate would therefore be the mass flow rate times the specific volume. Now, was this really a nozzle? Was the exit area really smaller than the inlet area? Something to think about here. I'll leave that to you, but the answer is yes, it is a nozzle. If you want to check out other examples in the nozzle, diffuser, throttling device, and pipe flow topic, make sure to check out the links in the description below. You'll find the links to other lectures of the thermo course as well as other engineering courses. Thanks for watching!